Hello students, today's video is basically on the chemical properties of ethers. Now the chemical reactions of ethers are divided into various categories. First is the reactions which involve the alkyl groups. Among that category, the first reaction is halogenation. When ethers react with chlorine or bromine in dark conditions, then the alpha hydrogen, then one of the alpha hydrogens with respect to the oxygen atom is replaced by chlorine atom. On further addition of chlorine, but the reaction should take place in dark condition. Another alpha hydrogen will be replaced by the chlorine atom. This reaction occurs in dark condition, but in presence of light and excess of chlorine, all the hydrogens will be replaced by chlorine. This compound is known as perchloro diethyl ether. Okay, the next reaction under this category is combustion. Ether burns in presence of air to give carbon dioxide and water. Okay, the next category of reactions are those reactions which involve the ethereal oxygen. Now, the ethereal oxygen The ethereal oxygen consists of two lone pairs of electrons, and since it consists of two lone pairs of electrons, this can act as Lewis bases. So in presence of air, or you can say that if ethers are exposed to air and in presence of light, they will form peroxides. Another thing is important, which is that most of the time in ether solution, peroxides are found as impurities. This is the main reason for this. And impurities are explosives and they will obstruct the organic reactions when ethers are used as solvents. So impurities has to be removed. Now a question is that how will you understand that peroxide impurities are present in the ether? For that, the test solution has to be treated with a ferrous salt solution. To that, a thiocyanate salt has to be added. Now what will you observe? If peroxides are present as impurities in the ether, then red color is observed. How is that possible? Peroxides are oxidizing agents. It will oxidize the ferrous ions in ferrous salt to ferric ions, which on treatment with a thiocyanate salt will give ferric thiocyanate due to which red coloration is observed. By this, you can taste that in a solution of ether, peroxides are present or not. Okay, the next reaction is formation of oxonium salts. Ethers, when treated with concentrated sulfuric acid in cold condition, will result in the formation of oxonium salts, and this is the oxonium ion. Okay, ethers are insoluble in water. Insoluble in water, whereas the oxonium ions are soluble in water. This technique or this process is useful in removing ether from ethyl bromide. The next reaction is formation of coordination compounds. Lewis bases such as BF3 or ALCl3 or Grignard reagents on treatment with ethers will result in the formation of coordination compounds. This is the coordination compound of ether with Lewis bases like BF3. And this is a coordination compound of Grignard reagent with ether. By this coordinate, these coordination compounds are formed by interaction. Hence, formation of these compounds will do not require any bond breaking. Also, these coordination compounds can be easily broken when required. Hence, sometimes Grignard reagents and Lewis bases are preserved in ether by formation of this coordination compounds. This is all about the reactions of ethereal oxygen. Next, in the next video, I will speak about the reactions which involve the CO bond breakage, as well as the reactions which involve the benzene ring, if there are aryl ethers. Okay, thank you.